WhosNextNYCRadio.com. WhosNextNYCRadio.com.
It is the Loudmouth in the building this week for Vero G with DJ Chef.
Yes, the one and only QB's future DJ Chef. That's right.
All right, and we are live this week as of course, every single week on DTF Radio, DTF Radio app, DTFradio.com, and all the platforms. We're worldwide from Brooklyn, New York. The historic Brooklyn, New York. And, of course, this is the Loudmouth on the Spotlight Radio Show on February 26, 2020. And
yes,
we are awaiting Chef. The man, let's get his music queued up. Hold on 1 second.
The infamous T.Y.
Oh, well, I wanted people to participate. But, yeah, let's check this out.
We're expecting somebody. You might have heard of him.
Yeah, it's infamous time. Say what? I'm swag tripping.
That's right. Infamous Ty's on his way. He will be live on the air tonight with us at DTF Radio. The man is everywhere. He takes over every stage he performs on. He has over 10,000 certified views on YouTube alone.
Wow.
And I think over 15,000 streams.
Wow.
He's big time. And he'll be here soon, Infamous Ty. So stay tuned for that. Live in studio, on the air. If anybody wants to call in, you could call in now. The number is 347-721-3161. That's 347-3161. All right, so Chef, the floor is yours.
Yes, thank you, Jason the Loudmouth. I got a topic to ask you. Since we're waiting for T.Y.
All right.
My topic is: Is it right when you pay to take a woman out on the first date? Is it right to do that?
Well, normally, you know, the gentleman, you know, pays, or if you got, I mean, if you're the one asking the other person out, then definitely you should be paying.
But in this type of world that we live in today, you know, women are getting more empowered. Women are
definitely,
you know, doing, you know, other things. So,
okay.
And the way I feel about it is, you know, sometimes women might take charge and say, you know what, I want to take you out instead of the man always. It is traditional that the man takes a woman out.
Yes.
It is traditional. But, like I said, the times is, you know, women are doing more things. You know, they're more independent.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're doing things. So, like I said, you know, it doesn't hurt for a woman to take a man out, you know. So, shouts out to all those independent women out there, you know.
Likewise.
Who wants to take a, you know, a man out, you know. I'm cool with that, you know. You know what I'm saying? Some men might be old-fashioned, and they want a woman to, they want a man to take the, you know.
I
want to
get
out.
Wine and dine. I want to get wine and dine. I want some lobster and steak. I want that being that jacuzzi, you know what I'm trying to say? You know?
Me, personally, I find it overwhelming for a woman to take me out, you know. I've had it done at least maybe twice in my life.
Why, you got a big appetite?
Yeah, crave a big appetite for...
Anyway.
Hey, listen, don't get me started.
Bleep! Jesus. Do we have a bleep button here?
Don't get me started, bro.
Yeah, you got a big appetite, ladies. Watch
hey,
out,
hey,
now.
Hey, cut it out, Jason, the loudmouth. And my other topic... The other topic I want to say is,
yeah.
Do you think love overpowers money in a relationship? That's the other topic.
It shouldn't. I mean, there's always a situation when one person makes more money than the other. You know, the other person is going to feel some type of way sometimes. You know what I mean? So that might be an issue. I mean, it shouldn't be. If you're truly in love, that should be irrelevant. But it does happen, you know what I mean? And some people take advantage of the fact, you know, that they have, you know, a higher income than the other partner in that. And, you know, so how you feel about that?
I agree that, you know, if you love somebody, if you truly love somebody, it shouldn't be about money. You know, it should never be about money. You
No.
know what I'm saying? You know, if you truly care about that person and you love them, and you want to spend the rest of your life with them or whatever the case may be, it should never be a money issue, no matter if you're going out or anything. Never let money control your relationship.
Definitely. You're very right about that. You know, because if the focus on a relationship is money, then it's not love.
Exactly.
You know, so, I mean, it's good. It's nice to have both, but if money comes in the way, you know, of love, then you're not in a relationship for love, you're in a relationship for money.
And then once that happens, it's not really a relationship. Like I said, then money takes powers over everything, and then you get torn apart behind that.
Yeah, definitely. How you feel about your boy wearing a Dwayne Wade, a Miami Heat jersey in the studio today? Oh, we got an incoming call.
Hold on.
Let's see
Hold
who
on
this
a
is, a mystery caller.
Hold on. I believe you. Oh, well, you got low with that. But you're on the air. Who's this?
Who we talking to?
Bossy V in the building.
Hey, what's going on, Bossy V? How you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. I'm listening to you, and I like the questions that are coming.
All right, so give us your feedback on the questions. Ask her the question. Go ahead.
Yes, Bossy V. I'm going to ask you the two questions that I said. The first one was, is it right for you? Is it right to pay to take a woman out on the first date? Do you think it's right for a man to pay for a woman to take her out on the first date, or do you think it's versatile? Sometimes a woman can pay for a man. Bossy, are you there?
Hello, you there? Bossy.
You guys are still there?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead.
We asked you a question.
Oh, sorry. Is my sister's phone is weird.
Yeah, well,
did you hear the question?
Repeat the question, go ahead.
Okay, the question is it right
to pay when you take a woman out on a first date?
Yeah, that's fine with me. I mean, I've done it.
Oh, so you think it's versatile that the woman pays for a man sometimes?
Yeah, I think we all equal with it. Like, I want to take my dude out, you know. I want to take him out. There's no sexist about it.
That's nice. I appreciate that. So take heed to other women.
Wine and dine, like Jason said.
Right.
So when you're taking us two out?
What happened?
When you're taking me and Chef out?
You crazy.
Well, taking you and the chef out?
This is a
double date. Okay.
Whoa. Well, we're just going out as friends, but.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't need to wind up on the first 48.
I like Olive Garden and shit. So.
Oh, you like the Olive Garden?
Oh shit,
I love my Italians.
Oh, okay. So, what's your favorite wine? What kind of wine of choice do you like?
So what other questions you guys got?
What's the first question that you brought up earlier?
Oh, the other question was, do you think love overpowers money in a relationship?
Love overpowers money. That is true.
It does?
That is true.
You think love overpowers money?
Yeah, love overpowers money.
Okay, that's good. I agree.
There is no man in the world that can buy love, so.
Right. I agree with you.
Yeah, love always will overpower anything.
Nice.
All right, so you're actually one. Actually, it's perfect we have you on the phone because you're going to be at a little place next Thursday night in New York City called the Karma Lounge. Explain to everyone about that.
Oh, yeah, so it's going to be my birthday bash, and I'm performing also, so I'm so super excited. I'm going to be the big 37 years old. I don't look it, thank God.
You don't look like you're 30. That's
because I don't do dumb shit.
Oh, I hear that.
I always got to keep my shit intact, because I'm a mother, you know, nice. Three, and I'm a working mom, too, so... And I'm an artist as well, so, you know, us artists have to make sure we fit, you know?
No doubt.
Definitely.
But I'm excited. I'm super excited to hear everybody else, too. You know, I always like to network other people, and I also like to get to know people and their music, you know, vibe with it and stuff. I did enjoy myself at the New York weekend last time. It was really, really epic, and I do appreciate everybody and their love and everything you guys done for me. I do appreciate you guys, too.
And we appreciate you. You have no idea.
These opportunities mean so much to me. You know,
and we appreciate you too, and
you know, and you guys are amazing doing this for people like myself that want to bring it out there, bring their talent out there. You know,
that's what it's all about. And
yes,
we can't wait to celebrate
your
birthday
for other people too. You know, not only because I'm an artist, I'm also here to help people to get out of that, you know, that phase where they're scared of performing, because I've been there. You know, it was not too long ago that I've been there. I was in my first performance in September of last year. So I started all this like that time, and ever since then it's an addiction. It's the best addiction ever.
Yeah, definitely. We can't wait to have you next Thursday.
You have a beautiful voice.
Thank you.
You have a beautiful voice.
Next Thursday you could catch Bossy V live at the Karma Lounge at 51 First Avenue between East 3rd and 4th Street. It goes down from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m.
Yes.
It's happy hour. All drinks are half price. We got bottle specials, hookah. We're going to celebrate Bossy V's birthday. Live performance.
Plus, it's going to be a music video shot.
That's right.
That's right.
You got your boy DJ Chef.
Not only myself.
Your boy DJ Chef will be on the ones and twos.
And I can't wait to see Jay Wright there too. He's awesome.
Yep, definitely.
He's mad cool.
Definitely. Well, we thank you for calling in and that, and keep listening to the show or watching.
No doubt. Keep tuning in.
And Infamous Ty will be here very soon, so we look forward.
I can't wait.
Oh, by the way, tell everyone that you will be here live in studio next week.
What happened?
You will be here live in studio next week.
Oh, my team will be live in the studio doing their thing. And me too, obviously. They're going to do their video soon with Jason. I'm so happy about that. And then me, I am going to be at the station very soon on March 4th.
That's
so
right.
Tune in. Catch me if you can.
Definitely.
That's right. Bossy V.
That's right. The boss will be in the building next Wednesday night at DTF Radio. And next Thursday night at the Karma Lounge. Get your tickets now. Hit Bossy V up. Hit DJ Chef at on IG, djchef.qnz.
Yeah.
Captain Clutch 80 or Diva and Diamonds. Be there.
Yes, be there or be a square.
All right. Thank you for calling in. And then keep listening, and we'll speak to you soon. Well, next
Bye.
Week.
Check you later.
All right.
Bye.
That was the infamous Bossy V, and she's going to be here next week on March 4th.
That's right. So stay tuned for that. And Bossy V will be here live in studio on the hot seat, So I hope you're ready. You're watching, girl.
And make sure that you call in. If you have any questions, to call in. That number, again, is 347-721-3161. Again, 347-721-3161.
All right, so I'm going to talk about a few things before we play our first artist.
Come on.
Featured artist song of the week, as we do every week here. I don't know what's going on. I got a little mic issue. Hello? All right, there I go. All right, we'll make sure. A little mic issue. All right. All right, so it was announced yesterday officially from Brooklyn Free Speech, Brick Television, Brooklyn Free Speech. Their committee yesterday, out of thousands of shows, the Vero G Spotlight, which airs in Brooklyn, I believe Saturdays at 12 a.m.
Yes.
I believe. It was announced yesterday by the committee at Brooklyn Free Speech, Brick TV, that Vero G Spotlight TV show was nominated.
Yes.
For the People's Choice Award, and we will be up for the award, and we'll find out March 28th.
Yes. We got to get a round of applause for that. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
So, this is a culmination of all the hard work that we've done. The past 2 years, and this award, just being nominated, is a huge honor.
Yes, it is.
And, out of thousands of shows, we were selected as one of the, grateful shows, to be selected, to be nominated for this amazing award. It's a recognition to all the independent artists, any guests that we ever had, either on a TV show, radio, any of our events, showcases, concerts, etc. Everyone behind the scenes that's helped this show over the past 2 years, including this man sitting next to me and
which
myself.
Is DJ Chef. But I want to say this, Jason. It's an independent artist show. So, by being nominated for this award, we're just letting people know that we're getting nominated, but it's through the artists, the independent artists. This is your time to shine. And we, by us being nominated for this award, is showing all the fruits of hard labor we're giving towards y'all.
Definitely. This just being nominated goes out to all the independent artists that have been on our show, events, all the people behind the scenes. There was countless people that helped us over the past couple of years.
Yes.
And, of course, last but not least, is the founding member of Vero G Spotlight, Veronica Gonzalez herself.
That's right.
So we want to give an applause to her.
Definitely.
I know she's probably crying right now. Like, oh, no, stop it.
This is for you, baby girl.
This is for you, Vero G. This is for you.
And look who's coming in the building.
So this is for you, Vero G. This is your moment, what you've been waiting for the past...
long time, baby
10 years. We finally got our first nomination at the People's Choice Awards. Definitely, that's recognition well-deserved. Many sleepless nights that we put in. You know, me personally, because I am the editor, I do a lot of the post-production, pretty much all of it, and photography. So I could tell you firsthand how it rose, you know. So it's just a culmination of things, you know. So just to be nominated is a huge honor. And even if we don't win, it's still a victory for all of us here, you know, and definitely indeed. So, again, everyone could vote right now. Go to YouTube, to the official YouTube channel of Brooklyn Free Speech.
And make sure that you like it. And you have to like it.
And the voting is a simple process. You go through the list of the People's Choice category. There's a lot of videos on there, a lot of different shows up for nomination. You find Vero G Spotlight. It's on there. And all you got to do is click on the video and hit the like button. That's it.
That's it.
And
very simple.
Right now, we are in fifth place. I know we still got a long way to go. We got 5 weeks to go for voting, but we're in fifth place right now. So just to be nominated in the top five,
looks real good, man.
You just keep it going. So this is definitely, you know, the momentum. We're building a movement. Like I said, the JM Empire Media, we are building an empire, and this is what it's all about. All right, so stay tuned for that. So, all right, so we're going to play some music right now and pay some bills with a couple commercials. And then after that, at the middle of the hour at 6:30, we will have the one and only. Hold on. Stay tuned. Hold on. Let me cue this up here. I know live radio here is like, you know, blah, 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 blah. Okay. We're trying to find this guy. Here we go. All right. Here we go. Who's going to come on at 6:30?
The infamous T.Y. That's right, baby. The one and only. With that too much sauce, baby.
So stay tuned. We got some music coming up from Bin Laden, Underdog, and a couple commercials. And we'll be back 6:30. Infamous Tide live in studio with the Loudmouth and DJ Chef.
DTF Radio.
Don't you go anywhere.
DTF Radio.
Walk in the club, all eyes on me. Swag dripping, a nigga really flee. Glistening, cool like an AC. Your girl like Tupac, got her eyes on me. She know I'm with the antics, I'm with any antics. She giving me brain, shit is so fantastic. She know a nigga hot, cause I come from the block. And I'ma make it to the top, and it wet her G-spot. Shorty give me sloppy woppy, then she calling me poppy. Then she ride me Kawasaki. She know I got it's me, cause a nigga really flee. And I keep a couple bands on me, you feel me? When I step on the scene looking clean, baby, too much sauce. When I walk in the spot looking hot, baby, too much sauce. Got killers with me looking mean, baby, too much sauce. Keep a duffel bag with blue hunnids, baby, too much sauce. If you know me by now, then you know I'm the shit, baby. Bring the bottles to my section, it's on me, baby. Anything you want and like, it's on me, baby. Cause you know I got the juice, baby. She messing with the kid, cause I got it like that. She know her old mans don't got it like that. Every time she asks, he said, don't got it like that. But when shorty asked me, I said, I got it like that. Shorty know I got the drip, drip. Pieces hit, and she knows she could get a lick. Forever stay bony, thought I played for the Mavericks. So pussy stay wet, so you know I gotta have it. Touch me, tease me, kiss me, please me. I give it to you just how you like it, girl. Touch me, tease me, kiss me, please me. I give it to you just how you like it, girl. When I step on the scene looking clean, baby, too much sauce. When I walk in the spot looking hot, baby, too much sauce. Got killers with me, looking mean, baby, too much sauce. Keep a duffel bag with blue hunnids, baby, too much sauce.
This is Bin Laden, Underdog.
Mistaking us for the fuck niggas that's out here. Burn about shit that's fake as fuck. This real life, I can't make this up. Like earthquakes, I'ma shake shit up. Made to the game, can't break us up. The best out here in the six is up. Most of y'all niggas fake as fuck. Even with a deal, if you ain't real, it's no big deal, bitch. I need a full whip that go fast as shit. And a big ass crib. But that might come with sin. Sin. We have rough beginnings. With this rapping, trapping shit, gonna have to happen one way or another. Put it on my sisters and little brothers. Don't get in my way, you're ducking for cover. Did you like chicken, you're getting smothered. With a recipe I learned from my mother. DJFradio.com. I need a foreign whip that go fast as shit, and a big ass crib to put my family in. That might come with sin.
With sin,
we had rough beginnings. With strapping, trapping shit, gonna have to happen one way or even another. Put it on my sisters and little brothers. Don't get in my way, you're ducking for cover. Treat you like chicken, you're getting smothered. With a recipe I learned from my mother.
Sisters and little brothers, don't get in my way, you're ducking for cover. Did you like chicken, you're getting smothered. With a recipe I learned from my mother.
DTFradio.com.
Yeah.
This next song is Crime Story by Hollow Creed. Crime Story by Hollow Creed. Here we go.
Yeah. Hollow Creed. Hollow Creed.
Listen up, it's not a mad one, so you know, get ready. Here we go. Story to tell that happened quite recently. Increasingly, the more you listen to me, you'll see why I can't be blamed, why I can't be shamed. If it was you, I know you would do the same. I was walking in the streets one day, me and my girl, her name was Venus, so I called out my world. Suddenly, dogs were approached by this guy, wrecking. Who is this little dick and why is this little shit talking to my girl? And I'm wondering who's this, and she's not playing no more. Now I'm pissed. I fell in love with this girl right off the bat. So believe I peeled this nigga right off the bat. That night she told me that it didn't matter. Confess she cheated on me, my earth shattered. It was with the same cat I took the bat to. When I was sleeping, they were fucking in the bathroom. Then she was out the door before I got off the floor. Good thing too, I was gonna kill the whore. I'ma find this nigga Rick, I'ma kill that rat slow. I'ma leave that cat at home, I'ma let that nigga know. The pain he put me through, he's in the hospital. So I'm hitting him with Vincent with no knife or pistol. And this time, I'ma make sure that he's dead. Went to his hospital bed, grabbed his throat and said, now to find that slut. But she filled up his phone, letting him know that she was waiting for him at his home. So I looked in his wallet, now I got an address. And $5 broke nigga deserved his death. So I pulled up at the back door of his crib, snuck up behind the bitch, kicked the ribs, covered the lips. Yo, you had me wiped up, now my life's fucked up. I have something to say before this night spills the cup.
This is the Loudmouth telling you guys the Spotlight Music Artist Showcase Series. Next stop. Hey, what's up, y'all? This is the Loudmouth telling you guys the Spotlight Music Artist Showcase Series. Next stop is at the Comma Lounge, NYC, on Thursday night, March 5th, 6:30 to 9:30 p.m., 51 First Avenue, New York, between 3rd and 4th Street, NYC. We got happy hour specials, hookah specials, live music, artist performances, DJ, chef in the building, hosted by TV radio personality, Vero G. Come out and just turn it up Thursday night, March 5th at the Comma Lounge.
Check out this amazing, amazing award shop called Balloon Awards, where you could get your latest plaques, awards, everything else there, customized at 3324 Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. Their number is 718-252-2792. Their email is BELONE1@yahoo.com. Check them out and show your support now.
BTFRadio.com.
And we are back in the building.
Yes,
there
yes.
you go. The second half of the show, and we got the heavy hitter on the scene, on the hot seat this week, the one and only infamous Ty.
Yeah. Check. I'm on live. What's up?
Ooh.
All right. Ooh. First and foremost, I just want to say it's a pleasure for you guys having me on your platform. Because, you know, I've been shucking and driving all over the city, outside the states and whatnot. So
we're just glad to have you here, brother.
Yes,
you know what
definitely.
Saying?
So
you've been rocking with us for almost a year now, right? And some change.
A year and some change. So you know the vibes. You know the bop, man. That's it.
Definitely. The first question I want to ask is, who is Infamous Ty?
Infamous Ty is a rap artist from Flatbush, Brooklyn, Caribbean native. Started when I was 16. I'm now 25. I rap, I engineer, I act, sell merch. I'm like pretty much an all-in-one, you know. I'm just infamous of what I do and the product that I sell. That's the person who I am, you know.
And when did you start doing all of this?
I started when I was 16.
Okay.
Technically, I started when I was 10. I'm lying. I started when I was 10, but I really didn't take it too seriously because, you know, at that time, it was just mostly, I had dreams of being a part of the NFL, being a part of the, you know, fire department and being a lawyer. But, you know, music had called me for some reason. You know, I just had a motivation of, you know, doing music. And at the time, I was doing poetry. So I was like, you know what? I started out 16. I took it seriously. I did some, you know, crazy choices by cutting school, being in the studio, recording music and whatnot. But
you was pursuing what you love.
Yeah, but I pursue what I love. So definitely, I appreciate everyone who's been supporting, who's been rocking from since day one. And you guys are amazing. I wouldn't do it without none of you guys.
Is there anybody that like influenced you to thrive for where you're at now? Like, because do you consider yourself at the prime of where you're at, or is there a whole lot more to expect from you?
I mean, there is a whole lot. It's a combination of both. It's a whole lot more, and then there's also influences. So I would say my influences. I would say 50 Cent is one of them.
Nice.
I used to go to school with him. He's a part of Pro Era. Desi Hines, he was one of my influences as well.
Okay.
You know, he influenced me to rap and shit like that. Who else was my influence? It's a lot more. I got a lot in the making, big events in the making, you know, a lot more interviews in the making, so.
Tell us what a big events you got coming up. I know you're doing the Apollo next week, right?
Yeah, next
Yo,
week.
Yo, that's
next
a that's week, a big honor.
Just get a clap for that.
Definitely.
Yeah, that's a big honor to be doing that right there.
Yeah, yeah.
The world famous Apollo Theater.
Yeah, definitely.
Let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. I had stories about that, but you know, it's about you. But for you to get that honor to be on that stage, that means a lot, man.
Yeah, because to be honest with you, opportunities like that is slim to none. It's mostly singers that get on it, and you will hear singers get on it. But as far as rappers, it's opportunities like that is slim to none. So,
you are right about that.
So if you're lucky that you pass auditions and you got a call back, consider yourself lucky.
One in a million.
Because it's like sharing the stage with the likes of Michael Jackson,
so many,
Whitney
so
Houston,
many, so many,
Temptations,
man.
James Brown,
the list goes on.
The list
and
goes on.
Jay-Z and
the fr- Even your grandmother's or great grandmother's
exactly.
favorite artist
exactly.
touched that stage some way, somehow. So for me to make it that far, that's really truly a blessing.
Make sure that you touch that what is it, a tree or something there? The artists is always touch?
Oh yeah, there's supposed to be a tree there.
There's something you touch
yeah.
before you perform.
Yeah, it's like a little branch thing. Yeah, yeah. What you're talking about. Yeah, definitely.
That's for good luck.
Definitely.
But you have plenty of that.
As far as tickets, tickets at the box office, please request for amateur night March 4th. There's different amateur nights, but the one I'm going to be performing is March 4th. That's option one. Or option two, you get your tickets on Ticketmaster. So hope to see everybody there, the ones who's been rocking with me, who's been supporting me as an artist, Infamous Ty, or supporting the brand Too Much Sauce. I hope to see y'all there March 4th, 7:30, showtime, baby.
Definitely, everybody be there.
Be there.
That's right. don't let me send the loudmouth to you.
Or DJ Chef, he might come.
Definitely.
Hold on, we got the sound effect here? Hold on.
Woo! Don't give him too much of that smoke, Jason. Don't give him too much of that smoke, baby.
They don't want the smoke. They don't want the smoke. But let's take a little break for a few minutes, and let's see if anybody wants to call in and speak with Infamous Ty. Oh,
man,
we got a caller.
Go.
Oh, my God, automatically.
Here we go.
Here we go. We got a caller for Infamous Ty.
Oh, who's the number? Who's that?
All right, we're going to put you on the air. Give me 1 second. And caller, you're on the air.
What's up, y'all? It's me, Will.
How you doing, Will?
What's up, boss? What's up?
I just want to give a shout-out to DTF Radio.
Nice.
And Jane Pie Media.
Thank you.
And Vero G, Spotlight TV, and DJ Chef.
Thank you, Will. We appreciate it, man.
Neighborhood.
Appreciate that, bro.
And inspire people and continue to do what y'all do.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. It's much appreciated, you know? It's all a team effort. I know you know this man sitting across. I don't know if you're listening or watching us right now, but we have Infamous Ty in the studio. Too Much Sauce.
Yes, I actually do enjoy his music, actually.
Yeah, so talk to him right now. He's right here.
Yeah, I'm on air. What's up,
man? You know, I know that, you know, I love his music. You know, I'm still waiting for the shirts. I got to get money for the shirts, and I definitely see him on Facebook and Instagram and all that stuff.
Okay.
So, you know, he got some good music out there, independent stuff.
I appreciate
and, you know, I know he comes to shows and stuff like that y'all do.
He's going to be at the Apollo next week on March 4th. He's performing at the Apollo.
That's the big stage,
amateur night.
Man. That's the big stage right there.
Biggest stage, man. Biggest stage of my career.
That's huge right there, man.
That's yeah, big time.
Definitely. So.
Yeah, man. They, you know, you got people out there that been on there, man. Hopefully you be successful there, man.
Oh yeah, definitely. It's all love and joy. It's about making necessary sacrifices. That's what I should say. Making necessary sacrifices, because I was there from since 5:30 that morning. People was camping out. That's how real it is. You have people flying in from all over the country. People flying in from all over the world. That's how real it is. So
serious.
Yeah, so it's serious business, and you got to bring your A game, because Apollo is not no regular showcase. I'm gonna tell you that right
now. Sure, not. Man.
It's not.
That's the big time stage, baby.
It's not. So if you know the fans gonna boo you, just accept it for what it is. I'm telling you, this is not criticism from your mans. This ain't criticism from your boyfriend or girlfriend, or criticism from your mom or dad or whoever. This is real people. Like, they give it up.
But I don't think you're gonna get booed, though.
Nah, I don't think so.
They better not boo.
I don't think so.
I'm going there with a stick on
the stuff. Some of the New York Knicks might get booed, but not you.
I told you better leave my Knicks alone. I told you about this. Told you about this.
How those boos are going, Will?
I mean, you know, they still young. They don't have a Jordan, so.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you. All right, well, thank you for calling. I appreciate it. And definitely call in again next week. And you're always welcome to come here in person. And we can have a debate. We could talk about NBA right here in person. You know, so you're welcome here anytime. You know, we're family. Everyone's invited.
All right, Will. You take care of yourself, my brother.
All right, you too, man. All right.
I appreciate the support. Thank you for watching and listening. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
All right.
Mm-hmm. All right, take care.
First and foremost, shout out Just Right for tuning in on the live. Shout out, who else I got to shout out? Chris Robinson for tuning in. Shout out Lonnie Lyric, GGMG, you know the bop. Flatbush Brooklyn, stand up. TRB in the back. Honor Die Sweets, she has some fire ass cupcakes, so make sure y'all hit her up for some cupcakes.
I'm definitely going to hit her up because I love cupcakes. I love cupcakes, baby. Her face. And not just the cups.
Her Facebook is Honor Die Sweets, T-H-Y.
Honor Die Sweets?
Yeah, Honor Die Sweets. So hit her up for some fire-ass cupcakes. Mike, I forgot his stage name. I know I did a yacht party with him. What's his name? But shout-outs to Mike. I see you. See you on the run.
Go down.
Mike.
Songless.
Oh yeah, Songless. There we go. Songless. What's up? What's up? Long time. Tavisha, Muslim rapper. Shout outs to her as well. My elementary upcoming hairstylist, Jessica. She had braided my hair like a couple years ago. Okay. So shout outs to her. She got a little business up and running, so making sure I support the black business.
All right, always. He's just a young black entrepreneur.
Yeah, I'm just a young black entrepreneur that's trying to make an honest dollar, man. That's what it's all about.
There you go.
Yeah.
All right, so let's get back. We have a few minutes left, so let's get into it. Let's mention a few minutes about, we were talking earlier on the phone about beats,
uh-huh,
about music. So elaborate into that a little bit for our listeners.
I should say artists need to clear their beats. That's just first and foremost. It's too many talented artists that is in the industry or on the rise, and they have some beats that is not being cleared. You understand? Okay. Ever since I dropped the Too Much Sauce record,
which has over 10,000 certified views on YouTube, and how many streams it got?
On Spotify is like 27.
Let me say this.
27K.
Let me explain.
Hold on. We need a horn for that. Hold on.
Let me say this.
Okay, talk.
For me to be a DJ.
Uh-huh.
For me, can you let me talk, Mr. Loudmouth?
All right.
For me to be a DJ, when I heard the beat and I heard them horns, I was like, yo, this is dangerous.
That's a
the
hit.
The way the horns came on, and then when the beat dropped, I was like, yo, he coming with some fire.
I should know, that's my entrance music at WTF Wrestling. You can check out on YouTube, WTF Wrestling.
Okay.
It's weekly on cable television.
Okay, Mr. Loudmouth, but anyway, like I was finishing saying, when I heard the beat, I knew that it was something serious. And I said, whoever is this Too Much Sauce, this infamous Ty, he ain't playing no fucking games. He ain't playing no fucking games, man. And ever since then, it's like, yo, I hear it everywhere I go, man. It's like, I don't know, man. It's crazy, man. Everywhere I go, I hear that beat, man. Too Much Sauce.
I mean, with that, the beat itself got 1.7 million views on YouTube. That's just first. That's dangerous, bro.
Weppa.
So, I know for a fact. I know what I was getting myself into when I was gonna release the record. I know that for a fact. I know I was gonna get into a lot of controversy.
That shit is serious.
I know I was gonna get into a lot of controversy. I know I was gonna get into, you know, people sending me their snippets or their versions, or mm-hmm. you know, I'm gonna have conversations.
You know, you made it when you have other artists doing freestyling over your beat.
Yeah, definitely.
Your track.
Definitely.
But ain't nothing like the original, baby. You already know, bro.
That's why I always tell people, like, yo, it's only one person that really got the sauce. That's it. But I knew it because, like I said, like Jason, he has sent me a video of an artist rapping over the beat. It was cool, but he just didn't clear the beat. That was the only downfall.
Bingo.
So
we're going to be coming after you with a bill. We're going to send a couple of people over to the house with baseball bats. This nigga. Capiche?
He's crazy, bro.
And then another, it's just like people been performing it. People been hitting me up. Like, yo, Todd. Like, yo, these people got you beat and all this extra shit. I'm like, I'll just tell people, like, yo, listen.
All right, go, keep going.
Look, listen, man. If they don't got exclusives, I don't really don't care at this moment. I mean, to this point, it's just another record to me. That's facts. Just my honest opinion.
But it's facts. Yeah. It's facts.
It's just my honest opinion. I don't hate nobody for using the same beat, because at the end of the day, it's hip hop. It's hip hop at the end of the day, you know. Because when you have ciphers, people have freestyle off of Biggie Smalls beats, off of Mobb Deep and Tupac. So
of course,
I really don't
people
care.
People use them beats all the time.
People use them beats all the time. So I really don't. I really don't care.
So tell us where people could find you and your upcoming events. Of course, we know about the Apollo. Give us the 411 on your upcoming events after
and
that.
And the big question I want to know is: is there another album going to be present soon?
Oh yes. Right now we're working on a project. It's going to be a love project. I have the name already. It's called Infamous Diaries.
ID. Woo!
It's called ID for short, like photo ID, Infamous Diaries. Nice. So basically it's going to be a full flex love project.
Okay.
So moving forward, I just want to create shock value. That's all I want to do, is just create shock value to the consumers, create shock value to the new people who's coming on board, things of that nature. And it's going to be love songs, heartbreaking songs, cheating songs. Whatever songs that falls in the category of love and heartbreaking is going to be in on the project.
Well, I can't wait for that. That's fire.
Executive produced by management, GGMG, Gem Gallardo, and Diamond Gem. You know the vibes.
All right. You know the vibes.
As far as social media, Facebook, personal page, Ty Murder Lifcott, the fan page, Real Infamous Ty, Too Much Sauce Clothing as well.
Yeah, tell them about that merch, man, because, you know, I want to know about that merch.
Oh, the merch, I just dropped the beanies as well. I dropped it over the weekend. I have hoodies, I have t-shirts, I have crop tops. I'm coming out with crop tops for the ladies. I'm coming out with different color shirts. I have 10 color beanies from gray, safety orange.
You heard that,
pink,
Will? Holla at him. Holla at
him. Neon green, blue, black, gray, white, and gold. I have 10 colors. Hoodies, I got gray, I have blue, I have black. T-shirts, I have black and white. It's for now, but I'm coming out with different colors for the spring, summer season.
How much is the hoodies?
Hoodies is 30, beanies is 20, t-shirts is 20 as well, but there's going to be a price change depending on the season. Nice. For the upcoming season. So some prices going to go up, some prices going to go down.
Gotcha.
It's about supply and demand. So
nice.
Definitely.
Nice.
Yeah, so.
So what's your upcoming events after next week at Apollo?
So March 4th is the Apollo. I have a couple pending events that it's not really confirmed. But March 4th, that's confirmed. I have South by Southwest.
That's major.
I'm going to Austin, Texas, March 17th, and I'm coming back March 20th. I just confirmed this today, March 22nd.
Oh, we got the exclusive.
March 22nd, I'll be in Philly for Stop the Violence Showcase.
Nice.
So, nice. Supporting a good habit. My sis Lonnie Lyric put me onto it. So, I'll be out there in Philly. What else I got?
That's the brotherly love state, man.
Yeah. March 26th, Indie Spring Fest. We got Gem Gallardo, Diamond Gem, Lonnie Woo! Lyric, MB, Slim Jackson, Infamous Ty, Reloaded Rose, the whole GGMG camp at the Indie Spring
Ill
Fest.
Lineup right there.
At the Indie Spring Fest at Blackthorn. Make sure you're there because Drewski is going to be there.
Nice.
DJ Scenario is going to be there. Who else is going to? DJ Roy Boy from DTF is going to be there. I'm going to be there. I'm going to be performing. So make sure y'all in the motherfucking building. So
all right.
I'll at my management for them slots because them slots is going by quick. Yeah.
All right. So we're running out of time, unfortunately, but we'll definitely have you back again. And we thank you for coming. So we're going to wrap it up now, the Vero G Spotlight. We'll check you guys out all next week. And we'll see you guys at Common Lounge next Thursday night, March 5th. We out.
Yeah.
Hey, trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, your sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Hey,
you got it, girl, you got it. Yeah. Pretty little thing, you got a bag and now you wildin'. You just took it off the line, no mileage. Waiting, hitting you the DM, looking fallin'. Talking while you come around and now they silent. Through the Cooper 17, no guidance. You be staying.